El problema. ओम सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। हरि ओम। First day, just three shlokas we studied, eight questions, answers. This is the first shloka, second shloka, and third shloka. Okay, first day, I'm not completely revising the subject, just touching. Second day, three shlokas, question answers, 12 questions, 12 answers. Prashna Uttara, 12 Prashna Uttara. Fourth, fifth, sixth, okay, three good. Third day, we have studied four slokas, 14 question answers. It is there in your notes. It is there in your notes. These are the four slokas. Fifth day, fourth day, yeah. Fourth day, five slokas and 15 question answers. Am I right? Right. Okay, 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 right. Carry on, carry on. And these are the slokas we have studied today, fifth day, the last. So we have to complete 9 slokas. Always these teachers are like that only. The last day they will rush. But somehow they will finish. In some places you need to spend more time, some places no need to spend more time, just you can go. Now we are going to cover 9 slokas, so 23 question and answer. Okay. Today, this is today's topic. So I'm not touching yesterday's topic here, because we need to cover 9 slokas, 23 question answers. We will jump into subject directly. Okay. Okay. So 16th, the shloka. Tasyasti nasho manaso hi mokshah kva sarvatha nasti bhayam vimuktau shalyam param kim nijamurkataiva keke hyupasya gurudeva vriddha. Okay, four questions, four answers. Kasya nasha mokshah asti. So, no, see, this is the sloka form. Then I did small anvaya. Anvaya means prose form. Okay. Kasyasi nasho, nasho manasohi moksha. If you want to sing, you have to sing as it is. Kasya, kasyasti nasho manasohi moksha. You want to sing. If you are a very serious person, philosopher, then make it the prose and read it. Kasya nashaha moksha asti. By whose for the destruction, or whose for the destruction only? Nashaha. Kasya, whose? Nasha. Brings the moksha. Then we will get moksha. By destroying what, we get moksha. Kasya nashaha moksha asti. We have to destroy one thing to get moksha. What is that? Every day I used to destroy one glass in my kitchen. Something I will break and destroy. This is a very, very difficult object to destroy. What is it? Manasaha. Manasaha. Manasohi moksha. We have to destroy our mind to get moksha. This is not an object. The brilliant thing is, this is invisible. A challenge. If it is visible, we can do it. We are ready to destroy if it is visible. Invisible. Manasohi moksha. Very challenging project. Life project. Every jiva has been given the life project to destroy the mind. It's a beautiful thing. Without destroying this, we are growing it. by pouring water, ghee, honey. So first we have to stop pouring all kinds of water, watering the mind, and we have to destroy this. This is a lifetime project. Okay, manasaha, nashaha, mokshaha asti. Very brilliant question, brilliant answer. Here only we have to bring the Vivek Chudamani. So Vivek Chudamani slokas. Note it down, then you can study later on. Just for your reference, I am bringing here. Vivek Chudamani, Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya says, Nahi asti avidya manaso atirikta, manasa. There is no avidya other than mind. Mind itself is avidya. Here you cannot ask, we studied, avidya is different, mind is different, buddhi is different. It's okay, we study. In this context, he says, mind is nothing but avidya. The subtle form is avidya. If it expresses, that is called mind. Nahi asti avidya manaso atirikta. Mano havidya bhavabandha manaha avidya bhavabandha hetu. This mind is avidya and this is the cause of samsara. The third line, fourth line is very brilliant line. Tasmin vinashte sakalam vinashtam. When mind dissolves or mind destroys, everything destroyed. The whole world is destroyed. Very brilliant line. Tasmin vinashte sakalam vinashtam. When mind is destroyed, everything is destroyed. Vijrumbate asmin sakalam vijrumbate. When mind gets up, the whole world is getting up. Very, what kind of line Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya show? Deep sleep, there is no world. Why mind is destroyed? So when you get up, the whole world is emerging. Why mind is coming up? The deep sleep. Deep sleep is a temporary mind destruction. But in moksha, we destroy the mind forever. Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya says, Bhagavan Ramana Maharishi says, laya vinashane. Laya means the deep sleep, the mind is getting laya. It's coming up like a ball, bouncing ball. So in the deep samadhi, in the samadhi, mind is getting destroyed. There's a difference between samadhi and deep sleep. Almost the same experience we get. In deep sleep, it's ignorance. It's laya. In samadhi, it's destruction. Is it okay? So the two words he is using in Upadesha Sar, Bhagavan Ramana Maharishi. This sloka from Viveka Chudamani. Again, one more sloka from Viveka Chudamani. I know you like this man. Sushuptikale manase manasi prani. In deep sleep, the mind is destroyed. Naivasti kinchit sakala prasindhe. Nothing we see in the deep sleep. We have forgotten completely. Our whole body also. Ato ataha manakalpita eva pumsaha. Therefore, manakalpita eva sarvam, samsara. Manakalpita eva pumsaha, samsara. All this samsara is the imagination of the mind. Because in the deep sleep, there is no mind. Therefore, the mind is the cause of the universe. So, very logically, he brings the point. So, what is the connection between mind and the universe? The whole universe is kept in the mind. If you destroy the mind, universe is destroyed. No need to go to office. No promotion. No money. No effort. No family. No family, first of all. You. Family only, all kinds of family. No family. Nothing will. So only one thing, if you destroy, the complete life is destroyed. Highest project of any spiritual sadhak, we have to destroy the mind. Mind is the cause of the whole universe. This is explained in the two slokas of Viveka Chudamani by Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. And one more point from Upadesha Sara. Bhagavan Ramana Maharishi says, Nashta manaso utkrishta yoginaha. Nashta manasa. If the utkrishta yogi, the great yogi, if he destroys his mind, kritya mastikim. After that, what he has, what kind of job he has in his life to do? Kritya mastikim, kritya masti. Oi, swastitim yataha. He attained his own nature. When we destroy our mind, we will attain our own nature. Thereafter, nothing, no duty to do in this world. Bhagavan Krishna says, if you attain your own nature, no need to any work in this world. Okay, nashta manasa. Again, here also Bhagavan Ramana Maharishi says in Upadesha Sara, nashta manasa. Okay, what duty is there for the exalted yogi whose mind has been annihilated. Mind has been annihilated. This is a very, very important. Nashtamanas. So destroying the mind. So what kind of experience we will get when we destroy the mind is given us every day by the universal Lord as a sleeping experience. Sleeping experience, there is no world. If there is no world, we enjoy only joy. Therefore, everybody is like sleep. Why you like sleep? Ananda Murthy. I became Ananda Murthy, forgetting the whole universe. Okay? So when we destroy mind, we get moksha. That is the point. Kva sarvata bhayam nasti. Which is the place where there is no bhayam, no fear. What is that place? I go to Kasi, Rameshwara, Chardam, or I go to Bangalore, my daughter's house, there is no bhayam. Oh, my son's house, there is no bhayam. I have a resort. When I go there is no bhayam. This beach, there is no bhayam. We find a place to get, there is no fear. Here, Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya says, Kva sarvatha bhayam nasti, vimuktau. In moksha, in liberation only, there is no bhayam. When we are liberated from this samsara, there is no bhayam. Why? In the moksha, only one thing is there. Sayekam. That Paramatma alone is existing. There is no second thing to get fear. Tritiyadvai bhayam bhavati. When we get the second person, then bhayam will come. There is no second person, only one Brahman. So in vimuktau, there is no bhayam. This is Upanishad point. Okay. When you reach Brahman, there is no bhayam. Why? There is no second thing. In the office also, we are the CEO of the company. When we become CEO of the company or manager, general manager or top leader, suppose if we make small mistake, at that juncture, one person comes and gets jobs in the company. The second person gets job in the company, immediately we get fear. Oh, yo, this person has come here for my job. Slowly the management will push me outside and this person may take my position. We get bhayam. I know you agree this. Even though we do not get bhayam, our boss is getting bhayam. We are enjoying it. Boss? Another boss has come now. We see so many things like that. Position. When you hold the position, when second person comes, we get fear. Bhayam bhavat, dutiyat. Enumimukti, there is no bhayam. No, nobody is there. Very nice answer. Param shalyam kim. Shalyam means very low kind of thought. Shalyam. Very low kind of. What is param shalyam? What is very low thing in our life? Nijamurkatae. Our own foolishness is very low thing. Lord, our own foolishness. Nijamurkata. So Bhagavan Adishankar is very, very clear. Swadehaha. Gora narakaha, swadehaha. What is very lower thing in your life? Your own foolishness. Nijamurkata eva. Very interesting. He's not allowing us to point out the other person. Why? Spiritual sadhak, first you have to point out our own self. Venama, unu venama. Saviya. So we have to... It's our own mistakes. Nijamurkataiva. Our own foolishness is very low kind of thing in our life. You see the picture. Picture says more. Picture brings more message. Okay. KK Hupasya. KK. Who are the people to be worshipped? Hupasya. Worshipped means to be respected. Or to be worshipped. Whom we have to worship or respect? Guru. The teachers. We have to respect. Deva. The Deva Ninda should not be there. We have to worship the gods. Gods and goddesses. Wherever we go to temple, if you see some Devata, you have to respect. Guru, Deva, Vruddha. The elderly people. So in India, when elderly people comes, we will not sit, we will immediately get up. The upasa. So different country needs a different kind of the culture. So where you are living, if your boss comes, you should not get them. The boss will not like. But we do there also. And a different country, different culture. But in India, so the Guru Deva Vridha. So we worship a teacher. Deva Vridha. Why? The higher place. Why we have to worship a Guru Deva? They are higher plane. Guru one who dispels our ignorance. Gukara, andhakara uchate, rukara, tannivartaka. Gu, the letter gu means andhakara, ignorance. The letter ru means one who removes. The person one who removes our ignorance, therefore he is called Guru. So Guru, in a higher place you have to worship. Deva, because we are manishya, Deva's got higher powers and they can bless us. We have to worship. Vridha, experience. Father has got experience, mother is experienced, our teacher is experienced, the old people, father-in-law, mother-in-law, all the higher, they have age. So our culture is teaching us, because they have taken birth before you, and they have experienced the life, you can learn from them, have some respect for them. This is the Indian culture. You getting it? There's a reason for it. So higher place is to be respected. That is the point. That's all. So we have to keep ourselves at lower level and we have to worship. Why we have to keep ourselves lower level? To destroy our ego. Otherwise we think, I am always high. Experience is there, Vridha, Deva. The blessings is there, Guru. The knowledge is there. Therefore we respect. Okay? Guru Deva Vridha. Abhi, this sloka, the relevant sloka from Manusmriti brought, Manusmriti, second chapter, 121st sloka, if you go, you can find this sloka. Many of you must have heard this sloka or seen this sloka from Subhashita. But the original, the source is Manusmriti. Abhivadana shilasya nityam vriddhopa sevinaha chattvaritasya vardhante ayuhu vidya yashobala. The person who respects elderly people. Elderly means not only the age. So they are elder and knowledge level. Senior study group member. When did you join the study group? 1 year back. Oh, I'm 6 months back only I joined. So I'm junior to you. You are senior. Respect. Okay. Are you Vidya Yashobala? When you respect elderly people, we get ayu. Life will be prolonged. Yeah, because they are blessings. Vidya. We get knowledge. Why? The ego is going down. We are receiving it. Therefore, knowledge comes. Yashaha. This young boy, even though he is a young boy, he respects people. Yashaha. Popularity will get. Balam. And we get strength also. Moral strength. Okay? By respecting these people, these four things we are getting. Manusmriti says this. Abhivadana shilasya nityam vriddhopasevinaha. Okay? This is the reference sloka. Reference are extra, the relevant sloka. Going to next the song. Upasthite pranahare kritante himashukaryam sudhiya prayatnat vakaya chittai sukadam yamagnam muraripada ambuja chintanam cha. Only one question, only one answer. Like first sloka. One question, one answer is there. Pranahare kritante. Kritante means the Lord Yama. Krita anta. So he is going to finish our life. Kritante. Pranahare. He is going to take our prana. If whoever gives us some problem in our own house, why you are behaving like Lord Yama? Yama. If it is a father, like Yama. If it is mother, Yami. I don't know whether we have word Yami. Feminine gender, Yami. Masculine Yama. Pranahari. You are taking my prana. So Kritanta Pranahara Upaste, when Lord Yama comes near to us to take our prana, Sudhiya, Prayatna, by effort, the learned person by effort, what is to be done? Himashu Karyam. Sudhiya Prayatna. Learned person by making his effort, what kind of work or action he has to do? When Yama comes, takes our prana, what the nice person, the learned person should do? This is the question. The one line is question, next line. Vakaya chittaihi, vakaya chitta, by speech, by what, the body, by trikarana. Body, speech and mind. Vakaya chittaihi sukhadam yamagram, sukhadam, that should, that will give us a sukham, peace, prasadam. Yamagram, yamagram means the one who, the activities, or the activity which kills Lord Yama, yamagram. Kritagnam, the word we have, Kritagnam means the one who doesn't have gratitude, one who kills gratitude, Kritagna. Here, Yamagna, one who kills, the activity kills the Yama. What is that? Murari Pada Ambuja Chintanam Chaya Murari, Lord Krishna's feet, we have to think. I know many of you got one thought when you study this, many, many students, I can see your face. Bhajagovindam. when you read the sloka, suddenly you get the parallel thought from Bhajagovinda. Actually, Bhajagovindam, okay, Bhajagovinda first song is kept in this life. Pranahare kritante upasthite sudhiya prayatnat kimashukari. When Lord Yama is near to us, what we have to do? Vakaya chitta isukadam yamagnam murari padam buja chintanam cha. We have to think and worship Lord Vishnu's lotus feet. Chintanam cha. Bhajagovindam bhajagovindam govindam bhaja moodamate samprapte sannihite samprapte. Upasthite sannihite kali pranahare kritante. Very nice word. The word is getting changed. The theme is same. Pranahare kritante samprapte sannihite kali nahi nahi rakshate dukran karan. So the grammar will not help us to conquer Lord Yama. Therefore, I am not going to any Sanskrit class. See, the sloka itself says, I dropped the idea of learning Sanskrit. When? 20 years back itself. What is your age now? Just 40. 40 plus. So these kind of slokas only protecting me from Sanskrit. Sir, this kind of slokas are told for the people, those who are in 70, 80, sir. Oh. If you have ability, you have to learn Sanskrit. We should not use this kind of slokas to compromise our tamasic quality. Not to learn, not to study tamasic. We should not compromise. We have to learn. Sanskrit also very important. But what age? Bhagavan, when Adishankaracharya, Bhagavan Adishankaracharya sees that person is more than 80, 90 year old, he is learning Sanskrit. At that time only he told, Nahi nahi rakshad dukun karane. Why? Well, the age is very old. So you are ready to, I do not know, Lord Yama is for that. Today or tomorrow you are going to die. At that time there is no need here. So you have to understand this sloka proper. The point is, this question, this answer reminds us the Bhajagovinda first sloka. Murari pada ambuja chintanam cha. And one very nice thing, when we are very strong at that time only, we have to think and we have to make punya. One person in the Narayana Divya Prabandham, the Sai Vaishnava devotees, the 12 devotees of Lord Vishnu, they lived in Tamil Nadu. Those 12 people are called Vaishnavas, in the Alvargal. One Alvar among them, Peri Alvar. So he only starts the Nalaya Divya Prabandham. Pallandu, pallandu, pallayirathandu, palagodi nourayiram, mallandu dinthol manivanna, un sevadu savvi thirukkapu. He starts in Tamil. He says that, O Lord Vishnu, O Lord Krishna, when prana comes, I don't have ability to think of you. Definitely I will not think. How do you know? I know myself. When Lord comes, I will not think. Therefore, now I am very strong. am very strong. Vakaya Chitta. Now itself I am doing this kind of puja, Sahasranama puja, Bhagavad Gita chanting and all, Murari, everything I will do here now. At the time of death, I will not think of you. Therefore, you have to take my name now itself. He says in Tamil, Appodhaikku Ippodhe Solli Vaithen Arangamana Gurulan. Arangattaravanai Palliyan. So now itself, when I am very strong, I do all my puja, japa, meditation, everything, you have to note my name, that's all. Now itself, I am telling, at the time of death, I will not think. That's all. Very nice agreement he makes. Very Alvar. Nice, le? Very nice agreement. And one more Alvar, that Alvar is Kulasekar Alvar. He is from Kerala. Kulasekar Alvar. So he writes in Tamil also, Nalayadi Prabandham. And he writes on Sanskrit text or Mukundamala. In that Mukundamala, he says that Prana Prayana Samaye Kapavada Pittaihi Kanthavarodhana Vido Smaranam Kutaste. When Prana goes, I will not think of you. Therefore, when we are very good, we have to go to study class, we have to go to all Upanishad class, Bhagavad Gita class, and we have to study. Very nicely you are calling us for the class. Yet understand this sloka. Because simple headache if we get, we will not go to puja. Simple stomachache, no puja. Simple problem, we will not involve the activities. Therefore, when we are strong, so we have to do this. That is the point. Okay? So this sloka brings one question, one answer, and it reminds Bhajagovindam also. Going to next sloka. One sloka, one question, one answer. Finished. Kedasyava santi kuvasanakhya kashobate yasadasi pravidya matevakaya sukada suvidya kimedhate danavashat suvidya. Here four questions, four answers. Kedasyava santi. Dasyu means thieves. Thief. Hey, that's how many thieves we have? Ayyo, so many thieves in my own house. All my relatives, they have taken all my property. Thieves. Very gentle kind of thieves. Not having any knife or gun, this and that. Simply they talk to me very nicely. They loot all my properties. After that only I realized, well, these people are dasyava. So many dasyus. So this is all outside. Now inside. Ke dasya vasana. Ko asana akya. Vasana. Vasana means our samskara. Ku vasana. Kuchita. The word ku. The letter ku. Kuchita vasana. All bad kind of the vasanas. Whatever we have inside our mind. These are all the dasyus. Dasyu means what? They have the outside. The thieves from outside, they take our property, gold, ornament, okay, money, every the property, everything they take away. In the same way, inside, the kuvasana, all the bad vasanas we have collected in Purva Janma, these kuvasanas are taking all our positive values. Adhe. The patience will go. Ahimsa will go. Satyam will go. All this word that... Sense control will go. Mind control. We lose mind control. We lose sense control. No ahimsa. No satyam. No aparigraham will not be there. We take all the properties. All good qualities will be taken away by kuvasana. Therefore, this inner enemies are kuvasana. Akya means it is told like that. Kuvasana. Very nice. See how he... reflected so deeply and brings this kind of question and this kind of answer. We cannot say this is an unnecessary question. Why unnecessary he brings this question? Because he knows answer, he brings unnecessary question. In our case, we bring like that only. I know answer, therefore I brought the question. The question is very, very relevant. So we are suffering in life with our own kuvasana. He says these are the dasyos and you have to come out from this dasyo. So we cannot say this is irrelevant question, irrelevant answer. Answer is very perfect. Question also very practical. Why? We are suffering. Therefore, we have to work on this vasana. one more point in the vasana and the action. So Gurudev says, I studied one of the texts, maybe in the self-unfoldment. Somewhere I studied. What Gurudev says, now see, the vasana, okay? Practically, this is vasana and this is karma. So vasana only expresses in the form of karma. You agree? Okay. Now in Avaika, this vasana is very subtle and this is very, you can see this action. So how to readjust, reset this action, vasanas? Gurudev says, by action, because action, you do some positive action, the positive action can bring the vasana, can affect the vasana to change the vasana inside. And one more thing, the same vasana is expressing the form of action. This got the two-way, knife. Very brilliant kind of, the setup. What we studied, vasana only expresses in the mind as a desired thoughts and it comes in the body level action. Okay, we studied the BMI chart. So Gurudev says, vasana is expressing its okay. By through your that good karma, you can reset your vasana also. So all the kuvasana can be replaced by good vasanas by our action. You see, we don't like puja, meditation and all. We don't like. Why? I don't have that kind of vasana. Okay. I don't have vasana to go to temple and I don't have vasana. Vasana means it should push us towards that action. But I don't have good vasana. What should I do? But to compel yourself, you go to temple, okay? Go to temple, sit there, even though you don't like. Even though you don't like, go and sit in the puja, go and participate in that. Slowly, 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 this action will bring good vasana. All bad vasanas will be removed. This is what he says. Very, very practical. Even though we don't like, just to start doing something, in the time, we'll get taste in that action. Slowly, slowly, the kuvasana will be changed. So we have to reflect and we have to make effort also. So in our case, whatever we like, we do it. Whatever we don't like, we do not do it. Then we will maintain the kuvasana forever. Okay? This is a practical way how to bring sattvasana. These are the dasyus. And related to this thought, we'll get one sloka from Bhagavad Gita. From third chapter, Bhagavan Krishna says, Indriyas Indriyasya Arte Ragadvesho Vyavasthitau Tayorna Vasham Agache Tau Hyasya Paripantino. Paripanti means thieves. Okay? Paripanti, when we move on the road, the thieves come and they takes our property in the same way. Two thieves you have in your life, Arjuna. Who is this? Who are they? One is Raga, another one is Dvesha. Raga, Dvesha. Two thieves. Symbolically, I brought here, okay? I never seen this kind of thieves in my life. Symbolic. One is Raga, another Dvesha. Krishna says two thieves in your life, Raga, Dvesha. Now, Hyasya Paripanti now. Raga, Dvesha, Vavastitau. So you should not go with these things. They are taking away all your good values. Properties outside, inside properties, good values, that's all. Daiva sampath, that's called sampath. That will be taken away. So therefore, you have to be little careful with this. Okay? Then in this sloka, all the three questions have same answer. Pravidya, suvidya, suvidya. Vidya, vidya, vidya is answer. Three questions. Sadasi kaha sobate. Who is glowing. Who is glowing in the sadas, in the sabha? When I dress up and when I do makeup, all the hairstyle, when I go into sadas, I am glowing like anything. Sir, you cannot glow. So many people are dressing up very nicely. Who is getting the brilliance glowing in the sadas? Pravidya, one who learned. The educated person is getting glow. The sadhas. Education is very important. Okay. Mata iva sukadaka. Like mother, what gives sukham like mother? Matha iva sukadaka. So vidya, again, knowledge only. So when we get knowledge, that knowledge gives us sukham like a mother. Again, next one. Dana vashat kime edate. When we give, what grows? Generally, whatever we give, when we give money, money is getting reduced. Ayyayya, my money is gone. What are the property I have? When I give, the property is getting reduced. Here, if you give, what is getting increased? Dana vashat kime edate. Suvidya. So when I teach, we get knowledge, more knowledge. Different. Dana vashat kime edate vidya. Mata eva sukadaka vidya. Sadasi kaha shobate, one who has vidya. This English. So three questions on one answer. Vidya, vidya, vidya. Therefore, we have to learn. So we should have the taste for the learning. Ready to receive, ready to reflect. Sogrihe pujyate murkha. The fool is worshipped in his own house. Why? He is beating everybody there. Therefore, all people are a little frightened and they are worshipping him. Sogrihe pujyate murkha. Sograme pujyate prabhu. Prabhu has got respect only his own village. Swadeshe pujyate raja. The king has got his own power in his own country. In another country, it doesn't have power. Vidwan sarvatra pujyate. A learned person, the person who has got knowledge, wherever he goes, is worship. Therefore, knowledge is very, very important. Okay? So, three questions, one answer in different form. Okay, lighting the lamp. So, we have the program lighting the lamp in our culture. Why lighting the lamp? When you take the light from one lamp and you light thousands of lamps, okay? The first lamp's light will not get reduced. Two things will not get reduced when you take from the source. What is that? One is light, another one is knowledge. Therefore, the lamp stands for knowledge. Therefore, we call this Jnana Deepa. Deepa means lamp. Jnana means knowledge. So, Jnana Deepa, the two words comes together. Jnana Deepam. So, why we are lighting the lamp in all our programs? Because light stands for knowledge. Wherever light goes, there will not be any darkness. Wherever knowledge will be there, ignorance will not be there. So light, you take so many lights, the first light will not get reduced. Knowledge you take from teacher, then teacher's knowledge will not get reduced. This is how deeply they thought and they brought this idea. This is Sanatana Dharma. In Sanatana Dharma, there are so many very deep things. If you are a very, very intelligent person, very brilliant person, if you are very high level, if you are there, very high level of evolution, then your intellect will be satisfied only one dharma, that is Sanatana Dharma. In Hinduism only, in Sanatana only, your intellect will be completely satisfied. All questions will be answered on all level. Yes. Purana level, you will be satisfied. Idihasa level, you will be satisfied. If you want more, then go to Upanishad. I want more, then go to Brahma Sutra. In all levels, our heart will be completely fulfilled. We have different kinds of food for the different levels of students. That is Sanatana Dharma. Bhagavan Veda Vyasa can go to this end, Purana he can write. And he goes to this end, Brahma Sutra. He conducts Balayar class, Purana. He conducts PhD class, Brahma Sutra. Bhagavan Veda Vyasa, brilliant teacher. Bhagavan Adi Shankara said, for the Balajihar, Bhajagovindam, Govindam, Bhajamudamate, Balajihar. Master takes. And Bhagavan, same Adi Shankara said, he goes and writes commentary for Brahma Sutra. So all students are satisfied. This is Sanatana Dharma. Now recently the program, they advertised dismantling Hindutva, global Hindutva, na? They cannot dismantle. They cannot dismantle even small grass also. They cannot take even small grass also from Sanatana Dharma. It is like, you know, like ocean, and it's like a banyan tree. So we belong to a great culture. So we have to be very proud of becoming or being Hindu, Sanatana Dharini. Next sloka. Kuto hi bhiti satatam vidheya loka pavada bhavakananacha kovati bhando pitarascha keva vipatsakaya paripalakaya. So this is one question, second question, third question, four questions, four answers. Okay, nice. Kuto hi bhiti satatam vidheya. From where we have to get this kind of fear? We have to have fear in life. See, our Bhagavan Krishna says in Abhayam Sattva Samsuddhi, Jnana Yoga Vyavasthitihi, Nanam Damascha Yajnyascha. In Krishna, in Bhagavad Gita, he says Abhayam. Hey Arjuna, you should not have any bhayam, fear. Now here, Bhagavan Adi Shankara says that you have to have fear in life. Why? Unnecessarily. Having fear is negative value. Sir, we have to again understand, having fear for a specific subject is value. Fear also value. This person never gets but the anger. He never becomes angry. So I was there in one of the programs for so many years back. Sir, unexpectedly went there. And the whole crowd was praising one person. Because he's leaving that person. And the last program we are sending, send off. And they are putting mala and a gift. They are giving and they are praising. He never gets anger. He's not a very angry person. He never used a harsh words in his life. What a soft person. Great this and that. Then I told him, sir, not becoming angry is not a good value, sir. Some kind of mental problem you have. If you are not angry for some program, your mind is not healthy at all. So anger is a very nice kind of value. But we should know where to use, where not to use, how to control it. Our Gurudev says anger is like a pen. So whenever it's needed, I will use it. It's not needed, I will keep it. Rama gets angry in Ramayana. Kalagni sadrusha krode. When Rama gets angry, he becomes like Kalagni, like Lord Shiva. That is value. The same way, this bhayam, the fear is value, where we have to not use, where we have to use. We have to understand that. Simply you say, this man never gets angry. Therefore, he's a nice man. There's some mental problem. We should have that power. So how to use it? How to manage that? That skill we have to learn from the scriptures. The bhayam. Where we should get bhayam. Loka apavadate bhavakananaschan. Two places we have to get fear. Loka apavadam. So the unnecessarily we get bad name, unnecessary loka apavad, the bad name from the world. We have to be a little careful. And bhavakarana. Bhavakarana means the samsara sagar. So whenever you see the samsara, you have to get fear of samsara and get fear of loka apavad, the bad name, unnecessarily bad name from the two places. The two examples, I'll give you two examples from our Purana Itihasa. When you go to Ramayana, Rama asked about that. Our Sita Devi to do the Agni Pariksha for what? Rama never doubted Sita. You go and study Valmiki. When you read the Agni Pariksha part of Ramayana, you get more respect for Rama. How he kept Sita Devi in a higher place is explained in Agni Pariksha. So we were told in a wrong way. So we got wrong message from wrong sources. We blame Rama for Agni Pariksha. Okay, you go to the original, you read it, then you will understand. You will get more respect for Ram. Loka Pavadat. So he is Janavada Bhayat. So Sita should not get bad name unnecessarily. Okay, for that, I need to bring glory for Sita Devi. He never doubted. Because we see things as we are. We are not seeing things as they are. That is the problem. I know you become so serious when I take this Rama. And even if you tell all the stories, I don't like Rama in one matter. What is that? Agni Pariksha. Male domination. Sir, you get what that material from what that not authentic source. You go to authentic source, read, understand, and you are convinced. Otherwise, I will not support Rama. Even I will not support Rama. You read and you get convinced, I am supporting Rama. You throw me so many stones, but I know how to support Rama, how he brought the glory for Sita Devi. He never put down Sita Devi, he never put this Sita Devi down. Always, Lord Rama kept Sita Devi high place only. So you have to read complete Rama. Okay? In another place, we'll discuss. In some other place. Much about this Rama and Sita Devi's story. Okay? Now, Jana Apavada. Rama was fearing for this kind of unnecessary Apavada. Sita should not get bad name. So this kind of the Pariksha. Not this is Pariksha. This kind of exhibition is needed to clarify the ordinary man's mind. Ordinary man's. Common man's mind. We'll get like that. And we have to live little carefully. This part from Rama and Avigan. Rama was little fear about these people. The second thing, Bhavakanana. Bhavakanana means we have to get fear of samsara. Samsara sagar. This sloka from Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 9th chapter, 15th, 16th sloka. 7th canto. In Prahalada Charitra. When Lord appeared there to protect Prahalada and he killed Hiranyakashipu. So Lord Narasimha appeared there. So after destruction of Hiranyakashipu, Prahalada started doing stuti. In Prahalada Stuti, you find this sloka. 15th, 16th sloka of Prahalada Stuti. Prahalada says, all people, oh Lord, all people, including Lakshmi Devi, is getting frightened of your form. Brahmaji says, Brahmaji asks, Lakshmi, Amma, Lakshmi Devi, can you come and go and pacify your husband? Ah, I never seen this form in Vaikuntha. It's frightening. Lakshmi Devi is getting frightened because of Narasimha Roop. Nobody is ready to go near Narasimha. Why? Now only he killed Hiranyakashipu. Blood everywhere. He is not washing his hands also. Simply sitting there. Nobody is ready to go near. Prahalada went near and started praising. It is there in 7th canto Bhagavad. When he was praising, two slokas, very, very nice slokas, he says, all these people are getting frightened about your form. Oh Lord. But I am not getting frightened. Prahalada says, I am not getting. He says, Naham Bibemi. Bibemi means I'm getting fear. I am not getting fear of your form. Naham Bibemi Ajitate Ati Bhayanaka. Ati Bhayanaka Rupa. Ati Bhayanaka. Asya Jihva. Your tongue. Arkanetra. Your eyes are like what is it? Sun. The power of sun, your eyes. Brukuti rabasa ugra damstra. You have karala damstra. The teeth is very, how to say, very ferocious. Your eyes are very brilliant. So all people are getting frightened. But I say, I am not getting frightened of this form. Lord Narasimha himself is getting amazed. Why, Prahlad? Why, da? All people are getting frightened. Why you are not getting frightened? This form is very simple form. And Prahalada says, in next sloka, Trastomyaham, I am getting fear. Kripana Vatsala, oh Lord. Oh compassionate Lord, I am not frightened about your form. I am getting frightened about Dussaha, Ugra, Samsara Chakra Kadanate. I am very, very frightened or getting afraid of Samsara Chakra. So your form is not frightening. Samsara chakra is frightening. Samsara chakra means punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jatare sai. This kind of birth and death cycle, this is very, very frightening. Looks new thought. But we are very comfortable in the family because we are in tamas. When we are in tamas, we are very comfortable with the worldly life. When we are very comfortable with worldly life, then we can understand we are still in tamas. Prahlada is a great devotee, great sadhak. He is not getting frightened by the Narasimha Rupa. He is getting frightened by samsara chakra kadanat tastaha fear. Okay. The two points from our Itihasa Purana, one is from Ramayana, another one is from Prahlada Charita. So these two points are brilliant values. Kutaha hi bhitihi satatam videya. So always we have to get frightened from where? Two places. One is loka apavada, another one is bhavakarana. Samsara sagar. So, bhavakarana means the forest of samsara. Sometimes samsara is depicted as samsara sagara, like ocean. Sometimes the karanam, the forest. So the two references from our Purana Idhyasa. Is it okay? Now, moving to next. Ati bandhu kahava. Who is the great friend? My relative. Bandhu means ati bandhu means very, very close relative. Who is close relative? I thought 20 years we are very, very great families. Last week only we have broken. Now only I understood who is related, who is not related. Everything is false relationship. Oh Lord, we cry like, I don't know whom to believe, whom not to believe. We have our own philosophies. And I'll call some many people, you know, I do not know whom to believe, to trust. Sir, you read the scriptures, you'll understand. Kahava ati bandhu. Who is your very deep relative? Vipatsakaya. You cannot say my uncle, my auntie, my father, my mother, my brother, my sister. No. So in the scriptures, you will not see all the relationship like this. No auntie, no mother, no what that? Chitappa, Periyappa, nothing will be there. Who is your relative? Vipatsakaya. One who helps you at the time of crisis. So that person is called relative. Not by blood you are not. We are always getting related to the blood. A blood relationship is not appreciated in the scriptures. He took birth. That's all. He took birth with me. That's all. I am in that family. But even though we are in that family, more problems the family members are creating in our family. I know that you will agree with my statement. All our problems, 90% problems we are getting from own family members. Own brother, own sister. All these people are creating. Why? Because I have property. And they are expecting. Because I am earning. They are not earning. They are expecting help from me always. How many times I help you? I helped them 20 years. Now this year I'm not helping them. 20 years of help they are forgetting and they're scolding at me. What kind of life? When I give them and they say you are greater relative. When I don't give them, they're scolded. And what kind of agreement they are scolding? Vipatsakaya, one who helps in the crisis is called a real relative. Okay, so all the philosophical point. It's not literally he's not speaking. Literal bandhu or relative. So we are saying this is Chittapa, Periyappa, uncle, auntie. That is not appreciated. That is not discussed in the scriptures. Vipatsakaya. Now see very, very nice sloka. Very nice subhashita. Utsave. One who comes to the Utsava period. Utsava period means what? That the celebration. Okay. Festival time. Vyasane. The festival time during sorrow. Durbhikshe, the poverty, Satru Sankate, during confrontation with the enemies. Okay? Rajadware, when you go to court cases, when you smashane, the cremation ground. These are the places the person comes and the person is being with us. That person is called Sabbandavaha. He is called relative. So you have to take this sloka and you have to check always. You just keep this sloka in your phone. Whether this man is my bandhu or not. He is not coming to my court. He is not coming to smashana. The meaning is, whether it is festival time or distress time, the person should be there. If he is not physically presenting there, then at least he has to call and send the message. How are you? Any help? This is called relating. Is it okay? This is very nice, Subhashita. Vibhataha Santuraha. Our Kunti Devi in Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, 25th Sloka, Kunti says, I want only Vibhat in my life. And Kunti Stuti says, nobody will ask like that. Will you ask any Vibhat in your life? Ayoyo, I don't want any Vibhat. I don't want any Vibhat. If at all God is giving me Vibhat, let all my Vibhat will go to my life partner. Or some other people, I have so many people, my boss, all Vibhat go to my boss, company. He's not giving leave. He will recommend it. Kunti says, Vibhataha Sandana, I have to get lot of Vibhat only. Why she is praying like this to Lord Krishna? Krishna, you are only my, what that, Bandhu. Bandhu. You are not only for my physical body, but that relative, like what, auntie. So she is Krishna's father's sister, Kunti. You are not, even though you are related to the physical, what is that? Physically from the family, but you are Atma Bandhu. You are not ordinary, but Atma Bandhu. Why? Whenever I get problem, you are appearing in front of me. Whenever we get problem, you are appearing in front of me. Therefore, to get your darshan, I have to get Vipat. See the prayer. If I want to get your presence, I have to get Vibhat. So Krishna's Vibhat Sakaya. Krishna, Draupadi is in distress. Krishna came and helped. Krishna is always with Pandavas. So he is the Atma Bandhu. Okay? Pitarascha Keva. Who is called Pita? The father. Who is called? Paripalaka. Paripalaka. One who protects the child, one who gives nice knowledge, one who gives culture is called Pita, Paripalaka. Paripalaka means all round. Palaka means what, that one who gives only food and cloth, that's all. Paripalaka, you have to give everything. Training to the mind and giving the philosophy and showing the way and showing what is dharma, what is adharma, all the things the father should give to the child. This is called Pita. So nowadays the Pita only give food, shelter, all the clothes, the pocket money and the property. And they never give how to live in the dharmic way. All my property belongs to you only. Then this fellow will spoil. I can sit and eat. Be my father worker, I can sit and eat. Sit and eat or proud feeling. Sir, your father earned. What you earned? Is your father's property you are enjoying. Father should teach him, this is my property. Till 14 years, my property will be held with child. Okay, paripalaka. This sloka, you get. Again, two questions, two answers. Buddhva na bodhyam parisishyate kim shiva prasadam sukhabodha rupam jnate tu kasmin viditam jagat syat. Sarvatmake Brahmani Purna Rupe. Two questions, two answers. Kim Buddhva Bodhyamna Parisishyate. After having known which, nothing has to be known. What is that? Kim Buddhva, after having known. Buddhva, after having known. Bodhyam, which is to be known. Which is to be known. I know this. After having known. Na Parisishyate. Nothing has to be known. What is that? Shiva Prasadam Sukhabodha Rupam. Shiva Prasadam, the Lord's Prasadam Sukhabodha Rupam, Atma Bodham. That means the Brahma Tattva. So when I learn the Atma Tattva, Brahma Tattva, Atma Vidya, Brahma Vidya, this is the Prasadam of Lord, Almighty Lord. When we get this Brahma Vidya, this is the Prasadam, highest Prasadam of Universal Law. It's not very easy to go and sit in Bhagavad Gita class, get the knowledge. It's not very easy to go and sit in Upanishad class, get the knowledge. So the extraordinary grace only we get this kind of knowledge. Okay, after knowing this, nothing known. That's all. This is the highest knowledge. This point is discussed in Bhagavad Gita 7th chapter 2nd shloka. Krishna says, "Jnanam deham savijnanam idam akshyame asheshatah yajnatva neha bhuyonyat jnatavyam avasishyate." After knowing this, nothing to be known. Just leave it. This is the highest knowledge. Okay, Krishna says in 7th chapter. This is a parallel thought. That's all. And Arjuna says, "Yes, nashto moha smritir labdha tat prasadat." He says prasadam, the word. The question has a Shiva prasadam. Krishna, Arjuna says, "Yes, this is Krishna prasadam." Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya says, "Sukhodo sukhabodha rupam Shiva prasadam." The Brahma Vidya Shiva prasad. Here Arjuna says, "Krishna, this is your prasadam, da." Krishna prasadam. What is that? Brahma Vidya. Krishna says, after knowing which, nothing to be known. This is the highest knowledge. So one question, one answer. The second question in that sloka, kasmin tu jnate jagat viditam syat. After knowing which, jagat has been known. What is that? If you know this, the universe has been known. What is that? Sarvatmake brahmani purma rupe. The all-pervading Brahman, when I understand, when I know all-pervading Brahman, then I can understand the whole universe. I know this question, this answer brings some Upanishad mantra in your mind. I can read your mind. When I know this, I know whole universe. What is that? Brahman. I know what mantra comes to your mind. What mantra? Mundakopanishad. Kasmin bhagava vijnate sarvamidam vijnatam bhavati iti. The question in the Mundakopanishad. What is that, my lord, having known which all this become known? Okay? This Mundakopanishad mantra only he brings in this question, in this answer. Therefore, we have to understand that Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya made this Ratna Malika. Prashnot Ratna Malika, from Bhagavad Gita, from Upanishad, from Idihasa, from Purana. Nice, le? From all places he brings and makes question answer form. If you hit the question answer, you will land at Upanishad, you land at Bhagavad Gita, you will land at Purana, Idihasa. Okay? Kim durlabam sadguru rasti loke satsangatir brahma vicharana cha tyago hi sarvasya shivatma bodaha ko durjaya sarva janair manojaha. Two questions, two answers. Kim durlabam loke, loke durlabam kim asti, what is durlabam? It is difficult to attain in the world. Sadguru, satguru, one who establishes in the Brahma, or the Brahma, or the experience of Brahman, is called Sadguru. Simply by name, Sadguru is not Sadguru. So you can call so many people by Sadguru, Sadguru. That is name, sir. In scripture, Sadguru means one who established. Srotriyam Brahmanishtam. Satpurusha. Sadguru. Sadguru. Satsanga. After that, following that, Satsanga should be there. Constant Satsanga. You go to live in some center, you're living in San Jose center, you get so many satsang there. Not deviating your mind, satsang. We have to go to satsang. Satsang is going on, but I'm not going. Sir, are you only satsang is going? Just attend and get some message. Satsang. Brahma vicharana. After satsang, we have to reflect. We should not give the message. Reflect. Tyaga hi sarvasya. Then we have to give up everything. Slowly, slowly. We have to giving up attachment. Shivatma bodha, then we get finally realization. So satsanga, the guru will take to realization. Guru, satsanga, brahma vicharana, attachment, detachment and shivatma bodha. Very nicely he brings. These are the things are very, very durlabham in manushya janma. This, the question answer remains Vivekasudamani second sloka. జంతూనాం నరజన్మ దుర్లభత పుంసం తతో విప్రద తస్మాద్ వైదిక ధర్మ మార్గపరత విద్యుత్తమస్మాద్ పరం ఆత్మా అనాత్మ వివేచనో స్మనుభవో స్వనుభవో బ్రహ్మాత్మనా సంస్థితి ముక్తిర్నో శతకోటి జన్మ సుకృతై పుణ్యై వినా లభ్యతే. All these lines, brilliant person, Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. You take over the birth, tasmad vaidik dharma marga parata. You take janma in sanatana dharma. Taking janma in a Hindu, as a Hindu, in Hindu dharma. Sanatana dharma, Hindu dharma is called vaidik dharma marga. Manusha janma, nara janma, pumstvam. Pumstvam means not here man. So he says manliness. The woman also can have this manliness. Vipumsam. Tato viprata. Viprata means you are not Brahmana literally. Guru says viprata means sattuguna pradana. Then you have to take birth in a Hindu dharma. Then tasmat vidyottam. Then you have to learn scriptures. When you learn atma anatma vivechana, discrimination between truth and untruth. Svanubhava brahmatmana samsiti. Then we realize all these lines will come because of the Guru Sadguru's presence. So we get the Satakoti Janma Sukruta. Satakoti. Satakrores. Okay. I do not know how many zeros I have to put here. 7 zeros. 100 crores of Janma we must have done Punya to come to in this life. Hundred crores of janma, satakodu janma sukurtaihi punyaihi vinan. These are our blessings. Sarvajaihi durjayaha kaha. By everyone, what is very, very difficult to control, to conquer by everyone? The whole world, what is very difficult to conquer by everyone? Sarvajanaihi durjayaha kaha. Manojaha. The emotions from the mind. Manaha. Ja means taking birth. The negative emotions which are coming out of our mind is very, very difficult to control. Nice answer. Nice question. What is very difficult to control by everyone in this world? The emotions in the mind. They are carried away by the emotions. When our knowledge is very strong, through the knowledge we can bring back the mind. The knowledge only can bring back the mind. If we very less knowledge, the mind will take us. If a strong knowledge, then we can bring back the mind. The person who has got knowledge and reflecting about the mood, then this person has this kind of ability to bring back mind. Okay, Manojaha. This reminds the 6th chapter of Bhagavan, our Arjuna is telling, Chanchalam hi mana Krishna, Pramathi, Balavadridam, Tasyakam Nigraham Anye, Vayur Vasudushkaram. So this question answer reminds 6th chapter Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna is telling, mind is very difficult to conquer. Yes, even the Krishna accepts, but you have the ability to conquer that. How? Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagya vacha grihyate. By practice, you can conquer. Answer also given in Bhagavad Gita, 6th chapter. Next sloka. So just 2 slokas, we'll finish it, okay? విద్యుచ్చలం కిం ధనయవ్వనాయుహు దానం పరం కిం చ సుపాత్ర దత్తం ఖండం గతైవ భ్యసుభిర్న కార్యం కిం కిం విదేయం మలినం శివార్చ. విద్యుచ్చలం కిం, వాట్ ఇస్ లైక్ లైట్నింగ్? విద్యుత్ మీన్స్ లైట్నింగ్. వాట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ యువర్ లైఫ్ లైక్ లైట్నింగ్? విద్యుత్ మిన్నల్, వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్? Dana Yavana Ayuhu. Our money is like lightning, comes and goes. Yavanam is gone. Gone. Yavanam has gone. Color is changed. Skin or that changed. Dhanam Yavana Ayuhu. My life. Dana Yavana Ayuhu is Vidyuchalam. It goes like lightning. So this question answer reminds Bhajagovindam, Makuru Dana Jana Yavana Garvam Harati Nimesha Kalaha Sarvam Maya Mayamidam Akhiram Hitva Brahma Padam Tum Pravesha Vidit. ఓకే మా కురు ధన జన యవ్వన గరు వై హరతి నిమేషాత్ ఇన్ ఫ్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ గోస్ అవే బట్ అవర్ లైఫ్ టైమ్ 70-80 ఇయర్ ఓల్డ్ ఇస్ వెరీ లాంగ్ వెన్ వీ లుక్ అట్ అవర్ లైఫ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టైమ్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ అవర్ లైఫ్ టైమ్ ఇస్ ఫ్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ ఓకే దానం పరం కి వాట్ ఇస్ పరం దానం దానం మీన్స్ చారిటీ సుపాత్ర దత్తం when we give danam to the right person giving danam to the right person is right danam the money should go to the proper place to develop it should get development not consume and ask again and again when I give money you have to develop it this example in the water you put a drop of oil the oil should spread at the top of the water the oil will spread at the top of the water oils in nature the same way jale yatha tailam the jalam even you put the drop of tailam it spreads in the same way the patram where we put this money that money should grow and it should develop is called nice dana asubhi kandangatahi api kim nakari even though we get what that the death when we get death by doing this we should not do few things what is that malinam malinam means very low kind of activities we should not do even if we get what that fear of death or death comes and it's frightening us even if I die I will not do malinam very ordinary kind of thing low kind of thing I will not do even if I going to die in my life malinam karyam should not be done even at the time of death also I'm ready to die, but I will not do this work, this job. Okay. Kim kim vidayam? What is to be done? Sivarcha. Sivarcha has to be done. And even if I get death, I will not do very low kind of thing. Is it okay? Yeah, okay only. This is the last sloka. Ahar nisham kim parichintaniyam. సంసారమిత్యాత్మ శివాత్మతత్వం కిం కర్మ యత్ ప్రీతికరం మురారే క్వాస్థాన కార్య సతతం భవబ్దౌ త్రీ క్వశ్చన్స్ త్రీ ఆన్సర్స్ కిం అహర్నిశం పరిచింతనీయం వాట్ ఇస్ టు బి రిఫ్లెక్టెడ్ డే అండ్ నైట్ వరీస్ ఓన్లీ వరీస్ వరీస్ సార్ వరీస్ Day and night, what is to be reflected? Parichintanam. Shivatma. Samsara mityatma. Shivatma tattvam. Samsara is mitya. Shivatma. Tattvam is Brahma satyam jagan mitya. That's all. So the Brahma satyam jagan mitya. Everything is mitya. Only Brahman is satyam. This we have to reflect every now and then. Okay? So he has given different formation. Samsara mityatma. Shivatma tattvam. Brahma satyam jagan mitya. Kim karma? What is called karma? What is called? Yat murare pritikaram. Parameshwara pritiyatam. When we do puja, we do sankalpam. Mama pata samasta durdakshaya dvara sri parameshwara pritiyatam doing this puja. So, every day we cannot sit 24 hours to do puja parameshwara pritiyatam. So, we have to go to office. Other works are there. When we do our activities, that should please the Lord. Which is pleasing the Lord is called karma. How can I please the Lord? Go to the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita from sloka 13 onwards. 13 to 20, all the sloka. Krishna gives an instruction. Adveshta sarva bhutana maitra karuna yevache nirmamo nirahankara samadukka sukakshami santushva satatam yogi yatatma dhranasya mayyarpita manobudhyo madbhakta same priyaha. He is dear to me. Okay? Same priyaha. Sachame priyaha. Samaya Priyaha, he is dear to me. He is completely pleased. Lord Krishna is completely pleased. Bhakti Manya Samaya Priyaha, Bhakti Manme Priyo Naraha, Bhaktasya Ativa Ve Priyaha. He is very, very dear to me. Krishna gives the statement in Bhagavad Gita. If you follow this, you are very dear to me. See, Yat Pritikara Murari. Whatever he says when we follow, Lord is pleased. Otherwise, you do puja every day, he is not pleased. Japa every day, but not following this. And Even though doing puja, japa, if you follow my instruction, I am pleased. Kwasta na karya. Where is kwasta na karya? Where we should not live? My house. First, I have to quit my house. Then, my office. What is your plan? Go to ashram. Where we should not live. Bhavabdav. In samsara, we should not live. So, we should not place ourselves in samsara. That means what? We have to get out of samsara quickly. That means what? We have to study, reflect, meditate, and we have to get released from the samsara. So, in the samsara, we should not live. Okay, this is the last question, last answer. Kandangatava, Shravanangatava, Prashnotarakya, Maniratnamala, Tanotumodam, Vidusham Suramyam, Ramesha Gaurisha. Ramesha Gaurisha Kateva Sadhyaha Ramesha Lord Vishnu Gaurisha Lord Shiva. Like Lord Vishnu's story, like Lord Shiva's story, Katha Iva Sadhyaha. Like that, it gives Tanotu Modam. It gives happiness. Vidusham Suramya. It's very delightful and it gives happiness for the learned people when we study this Prashnotara Ratna Malika. Prashna Uttara Ratna Mala. So, whoever studies the learned person, the Prashna Uttara Ratna Mala, they get happiness and they get, what do you call, the delightfulness in their heart. How? Like Lord Vishnu story, like Lord Shiva story. Okay? When you talk Kandangata, when you hear, the person who talks, the person who hears, both are getting delightful experience because of this Ratna Mala. Like Lord Shiva stories, like Lord Vishnu stories. So with this, so we are concluding this. So totally we have studied 24 slokas and questions, 72 question answer. As I told you few days back, I have edited. Edited means not touching the sloka. I removed few slokas from this. And that is not relevant. Not needed. No. Therefore. It needs different, the argument, different kind of presentation. Therefore, not needed. So, yeah, 2-3 slokas I removed, that's all. Not much, 20-30, no. I'm not touching the original sloka, just removed a few slokas. So, 24 slokas you have studied, question answer, 72 questions, 72 answers. So, you can take this and you can conduct some you can make it an English question answer and give it to some children. A higher class children, and you can make them some more that fill in the blanks or match the following or some kind of quiz kind of thing you can give. You can make use of this. This is in Sanskrit. You convert it into English and you can make use of, make it very interesting. Okay. And Prashnotara Ratna Malika, Purana Idihasa and Symbolic. Okay. This is one standpoint. This is not discussing Puranic, it has a symbolic standpoint. It not gives a symbolic or this kind of. So this Ratna Malika is a philosophical, psychological standpoint. So this is intellectually it deals. All the answers are philosophical, psychological, intellectual. This is not dealing like a Purana Idiyasa and a symbol. Getting it? Okay. So this standpoint is not here. So we studied this standpoint. Why? We are all very brilliant. Intelligent people. We don't want answer. We want answer philosophical, psychological, practical. All the answers are like this only. So Prashnotara Ratna Malika is like this only. All the answers, if you check, very, very practical. Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma's ability to give like this also, like this also. Ratna Malika is in this standpoint we studied. Okay. Prashnodana, these are the Ratna Malika. Please take this mala and wear it on your neck and lead life very happily. Okay? Thank you very much for listening this for 4 days. I will send all this life to our Jigneshji. So Jigneshji will share. If you want, you take whatever I brought this, I will send you. Then you can use for your own class, for your some other purpose, you can use it. Otherwise, you keep it in the, anyway, Navaratri comes. You keep it in the Navaratri Golu and you do puja. That's all. That is up to you. Okay, I will send everything. So thank you very much for listening to. Always few centers are very, very happy centers. So one among those centers, San Jose. Thank you very much. But I'm not able to present physically, but by God's grace, we'll see in the future. Okay. Very happy to see you all. I can see you all, but you can see me only. It is like Bhagavad Gita. So I see you all on the screen. But this kind of WebEx, it has got, you can see only me. I see all your faces are glowing like anything. Why? Because you studied Ratnamalika and you started wearing Ratnamala also. Okay? And these are the